ColorGate, always a good question, what kind of company is it? Is it a RIP company? Is it a software company? Is it a workflow company? We prefer to say that we are a digital imaging knowledge company because this is what we are actually doing. 40 employees, most of them based in the headquarter in Hanover, Germany. Some of them are also abroad, making sure and sustaining our global service and support network. So we are covered in all of the major regions of the world. 600 sales partners over the years. We work with 90 OEMs. I think it's an amazing number. And we have developed 1,700 printer drivers in the years. There are like 15,000 licenses out there in the field. And we've been in this area the last 22 years. ColorGate has a proud heritage in the analog proofing systems like the Matchprints and the Chromalines with the digital version, with the software version. It was a great booming market back in these days. Nowadays, this market is a little bit more mature, so there are no super strong growth rates in this area, but still it's a market that we take very serious. We are proud of our heritage there, and we are still very active in that. However, Thomas, our CEO, had the great vision already 10 years ago that future growth might need to come from somewhere else. So ColorGate started this expansion into the industrial printing market. Our focus areas in industrial printing are ceramics, decor, packaging, and textile. The main challenges here are a little bit different from what you see in the commercial printing market. In the commercial printing market, the challenge is usually like, I want to make one device, like my large format printer, color-wise behave like an offset press. So it's about managing colors in different applications, in different situations, in different viewing conditions. In industrial printing, or print on what you sell, as we like to say, the challenges are a little bit different. They are mostly about quality assurance, recognition and fixing of color deviations, and digitizing of processes that were analog before, increase efficiency, and really employ our technology in order to improve somebody's profitability, numbers, and a few other things. Why ColorGate? Because we have an excellent industry network, so we are very closely connected with the big inkjet manufacturers, with software partners, measuring devices. This is really where our expertise. We work with high quality components. We have very strong collaboration with Adobe, talking a lot all the time. Most of the print designs, most of the file that are used in the industry are produced in the one way or another with an Adobe application. So it makes a lot of sense for us, of course, to partner closely with them. The software has an excellent performance. We don't want those ripping and color management applications to become the bottleneck of the production process. The software is very modular, very scalable. When you have a look at the website, it works almost like a car configurator, so you pick exactly what you want. You don't pay for features that you don't need. The color rendering has really high quality, so we are usually brought in the picture when it really comes to high quality, good color matching, good visual impression. And of course, we have dedicated expertise in ceramics, textile, decor, packaging applications. Ceramics, decor, this is definitely with Jan. I have a little bit of a textile background and packaging, and of course the overarching image is, let's say in the head of Thomas, of our business development team. So this knowledge is really widely distributed. Okay, so much for my introduction, and now I would like to hand over to Jan. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Good.
Yeah, thank you very much, Oliver. So now I need to hurry up a little bit that I don't exceed the time too much. So I will speak about digital decoration of ceramic tiles today. And to start with, I first would like to outline a little bit the challenges that you have when it comes to digital decoration of ceramic materials. For that reason, I've prepared a short video that should give you an overview how a ceramic tile production environment looks like. So you will see there a glazing line, a kiln, a press. So those of you who are not familiar with the ceramic production can imagine a little bit better. During the video, we will also hear a little bit about the challenges that this industry have to deal with. After the video, I will conclude these challenges a little bit before introducing a new approach to ICC profiling, which is the fingerprint to a standard profile, and how does the workflow around this technology looks like, and how does it address the challenges that you have in a ceramic production. The last point will be about measurement devices. So still today, it's common practice in this industry to work with typical spectrophotometers. And we will have a look into the problems that you have when using such devices for color characterization on a tile. And after that, I will explain a little bit the advantages that you would have when using a dedicated instrument that has been built for this purpose, for measuring on complex surfaces. And last, we will have a really short sneak peek about some possibilities from the Surface VD device, beside measuring, that gives you some nice possibilities in the designing process already. Okay, let's start with the video.
The color consistent rerun of a design is one of the major challenges in the digital ceramic tile decoration process concerning workflow and color management. Why is it so difficult to reproduce an existing floor tile design that matches the initial one accurately in color? Tiles are made from natural raw materials that slightly vary. These variations influence the quality of the commodities. The change of the production line or any modification of the burning process will have an impact on the color appearance of the final product. For this reason, it is today's common practice to retouch the digital design file until it finally matches the master tile, which is very time-consuming. Over and over again, the models have to be retouched, printed, fired, and compared with a reference. This prevents a steady line flow in tile production and leads to inefficiencies.
Wir hatten vor einem Dreivierteljahr einen Austausch von Tinten vorgenommen.
9 months ago, we had exchanged inks and had to reset each image completely, which was a very complex process involving 70 or 80 products to convert. This took more than 6 months. And of course, this restricted production, which led to delays that blocked us a bit in our plans. A test run on ceramic tiles simply takes a long time. You have to go into production, you have to glaze tiles, then print them, and afterwards they have to be fired. Perhaps the kiln is not at the right temperature to fire the attempt, but that should be precise, because otherwise you get deviations that you can't assess afterwards. The whole process takes 2 to 4 hours, and sometimes more, because you might have to wait until the kiln has reached the right temperature. Because of this, it's very helpful if you can simply reduce the number of these production cycles.
With several new Surface 3D and ColorGate's fingerprint technology, these waiting times have been considerably reduced. In addition, it is now much easier to work across locations.
With the METIS scanner, we can scan the fingerprint much faster. What used to take a quarter of an hour is now done in 10 seconds. This means that the target is read in, can be processed much faster, and it makes the workflow more efficient.
Different formats and glazes, for example of a design series or collection, require different kiln profiles and firing curves, which can lead to varying effects on the color development.
In the past, we often had to adjust each file individually, adjusting them according to the firing curve. But today, we have the fingerprint and can use one file for everything.
So this video was part of a user story that we recently did with one of our customers, Deutsche Steinzeug. The whole video can be found on our website, so it's a little bit longer than this version. And if this topic of digital decoration of tiles is of interest, I really recommend you to have a closer look, since the Deutsche Steinzeug really gives nice insight into a real ceramic production. So. We had about challenges in a ceramic production. So a very big challenge is that you have very often changing and non-standardized raw materials, and the properties of these materials have an influence on color development. Then there is a really, really complex production process with compounding, pressing, glazing, and the firing process. And especially the firing process is key, since the final color development takes place in the different zones will have a huge impact on the color development. And since different format require different kiln profiles, when you think on a design series containing, for example, 30 by 60 and a 60 by 60 tile with the same decor, they need to be fired under different conditions, and it can be really challenging to achieve the same result there, because this component of the design series is supposed to be applied on the floor together in order to create a nice pattern, so they really need to look absolutely the same. Then you don't have standardized ink sets in ceramic due to the fact that you cannot use organic pigments. They would just burn away in the kiln. You have to use mineralic ones. So instead of a cyan, you have a cobalt blue. Instead of a magenta, you have a red-brown. You have a beige, an orange. And sometimes five colors, six colors, effect inks, color configurations without black. So this already can be quite challenging for software. Even if you work with Photoshop, you maybe know that there are a lot of restriction when it comes to multi-channel data. So to build an workflow that is taking into consideration all these production-related parameters is really already quite challenging, especially with standard color management tools that are available on the market. And you have also to think that the people working in those productions are not color management experts. So at Colorgate, we thought about how could we help those people, how could we do their life a little bit easier and to bring some structure in this chaotic and changing production conditions. And as a result, we invented the fingerprint module. So this have two main goals, I would say. The first goal is to provide a workflow that enables an operator in a ceramic printing environment to handle all these fluctuations and changing in production in a quite easy way. And the second goal has to do with another specialty when it comes to flooring designs. And this is the fact that in comparison with a photographic motif, you have inside a flooring design only a few colors. So to understand that a little bit better, let's have a look to a standard ICC profile, or better, the measurement data of a standard ICC profile. So you see here you have a homogeneous distribution of measurement data all over your gamut. So maybe you printed 1,200 colors, and from this data a software can calculate an printing profile. So you can send files through this profile in order to get separations to print these files. Maybe your ceramic printer is capable of printing 200,000 different colors. You have measured 1,200 of them. That means all the other colors will be interpolated by your software. This interpolation can be good, or can be at some places maybe not that good, where you have some holes here into the gamut. If you're now going to send a photographic picture that contains of hundreds or thousands of different colors, you will probably be fine. Because even if some colors are not rendered 100% accurately, it will be hidden in the total picture, so your result will be okay. If you look now to a typical design that you can find in the flooring industry, like this marble, for example, the things look a little bit different. So instead of really colorful designs. You have a design like this marble, so you have only a few colors, but a lot of different shades of these colors. And only a few points that are really describing the colors of your design. If you would transfer the colors of your design into a gamut, it would look more like that. So you would have a dense cloud of nearby colors located in a narrow area of a color space. And this is exactly the approach that we took with the fingerprint technology, that we focus more on characterizing the design instead of characterizing the printer. So a set of fingerprint measurements would look like that. You have the, yeah, let's say the bones, the skeleton of the profile, and embedded the information about the color of your design. How do we do that? So when sending your design to the printer, the ceramic production server, the RIP, is generating print data. From this print data, we extracting the tonal values and we transform it in a measurable layout. This looks like a target that you maybe know from standard ICC profiling. So this target will then send to production, will be measured, and after you have this colorimetric specification of your design, we will bundle this data together with the print data in order to form the fingerprint production file. And this fingerprint production file includes the colorimetric specification of your design. And it will represent the digital master for the future when it comes to reprints, no matter if it is on the same line, on a different line, or even at a complete different location. And because we embed this colorimetric specification of the colors into the file, the rendering to create new output data for reproduction is really precise. So how does the workflow around this technology look like? First, you have your initial production, and that's the time where you are creating your fingerprint. So you are sending your design file to the ceramic production server. The ceramic production server will generate separations, so print data, and will also generate a design-related target containing the colors of your design. Both files, the design and this target, will be sent to production and processed through the whole production chain. That means that every parameter inside the production that influences the development of the design, the color development of the design, will influence in absolutely the same way the connected patch on the target. After the kiln, you take the target, you put it in the rabbit spectre cube or in another measurement device, and you will receive what we call fingerprint measurements, because it represents the colorimetric specification of your design. Those measurements are then sent back to production server, and together with the print data, the production server is generating the fingerprint production file. Now it comes to reproduction of your decor 2 weeks later, 3 months later, on a different location. So you're going to send the fingerprint production file, including the colorimetric specification of your design, back to the ceramic production server. You choose your intended output, so on which printer you would like to produce your design next. And then from this fingerprint production file, the production server is generating you new print data in order to match your initial production on the same printer or even a different printer. And in 95% of the cases, we have an immediate match between your initial production and the reproduction. In some cases, there is the need to have, let's say, 1 to 3 iterations in order to get rid of a last small color shift. Making a test in ceramics takes quite a long time, 2 hours up to 4 hours, and this is just to get the target. This can also take up to 1 hour or even more. It depends. And now, I told you that with the fingerprint approach, you need to do a profile for each design and also measure more patches. Yes, we also thought about this problem. And our goal was to drastically reduce the time that is needed to build an ICC profile. And it's not only the the time, which is very critical in industrial production. It is also the fact that you have some other problems when you work with typical spectrophotometers that are made for the graphic applications for measuring on paper. For example, with tile, you have very often a strong glossiness, and it's not only a glossy surface. Basically, it is a layer of glass that is above your printing layer. So when the light is passing through this layer, it comes to optical effects, and spectrophotometer, a typical one, it's just not designed to handle such situations. Then you have problem with the size and the thickness of tiles. So tiles for auto use, for example, sometimes they are just too big to fit into an automatic table, or tiles that are sized 60 by 60, for example, needs to be cut before you can put it in a table, which is some extra effort. And in most cases, you have to measure your target by hand and cannot use an automatic table, which makes the thing even more time-consuming. Another problem is that tiles very often have a structure. For safety reasons, or just because it looks quite nice to have a wooden decor that has also some touchable structure on it. You can see it a little bit bigger, but trying to measure a surface like that with a standard photospectrometer will not work at all. First, it will lead to wrong measurements, and second, you probably damage your measurement head, or you have a really strong abrasion. Yeah, that's the reason why we invented, or we thought about how should a measurement device look like to solve the problems that you have in environments like, for example, ceramic. The first thing was that we thought, okay, we need to build a device that is seeing or recognizing the colors more in the same way like the human eye instead of a photospectrometer. You can see here the geometry of a typical spectrophotometer. We will see it a little bit bigger on the next slide. So you have two light sources from left and right, and they are sent in a 45 degree angle to a substrate, and they are supposed to be reflected in a right angle into the sensor. And this is working quite well on paper. But yeah, when it comes to complex surfaces, the problem starts here. And also, you have to move this small aperture from this device from patch to patch, measuring every color individually, which takes a lot of time. In comparison, the Rapid SpectroCube is able to capture a whole target at one time. So instead of 1-2 hours of measuring, the measuring process takes only a couple of seconds, no matter how many patches you would like to measure. The second thing is that we have a completely different light distribution inside, so it's omnidirectional. That means we have light on every side, and it's also emitting light in all directions. We have a wide aperture on top that is located with a distance to the target, so the light will be perceived from this sensor more or less in the same way like a human standing above a tile and have a look to the color. So the impression is quite similar. Here you see the geometry in a schematic. Here you can see what happens when you have a structured surface. Yeah. So light is reflecting in different angles, and you can see it here that a lot of light is hitting inside the instrument against the wall. So you're going to lose a lot of information. Just a part of the light is received by the sensor. If you now have a look at the Rapid SpectroCube architecture, the things look a little bit different. So there is big light sources located here. The light is emitted in every angle, and even if it is bouncing around, finally it reaches at the aperture, and all the light will be collected and can be used for color characterization. The second problem that you have is this glass layer above a tile. This is a translucent object. That means if you send the light in this angle to your surface, the light will guide it through, and some of the reflection will just take place outside the measurement device. Also, you have some refraction effects, and even here, or the same here like an example before, it will lead to wrong measurements. Also with a rapid spectre cube, no matter if the light is guided through this glass layer a little bit after it will be reflected, we're finally going to collect all the light and doing a proper characterization of the color. You can also put in tiles up to 60 by 60 for the Surface 3D, which we see in a couple of minutes. The size is, I think, 49 by 89 centimeters. You are able to process up to 10,000 patches per target. You will probably not need this big amount of patches, but if you think on a six-color device in ceramics, using the fingerprint approach, you can easily end up with 5,000 or 6,000 patches to measure. Yeah, and with this device, you can also measure this amount of patches in only a couple of seconds. It's also possible to measure from extremely small objects. So if you think on mosaic tiles, for example, you cannot place a lot of patches on that. With this technology, it is able to have a diameter from just 1 square millimeter. So even on small objects, you can place a decent amount of patches in order to do a proper color characterization. Here you see a few examples besides ceramics, for example, carpets or small objects like bottle caps, high reflecting objects, also metallic surfaces, for example. With this technology and with this device, you are able to measure all these complex surfaces. Okay, the last point. There is an option beyond the Rapid Spectre Cube, and this product is called 3D Surface Director. So beside all the advantages when it comes to measurement that I explained it over the last slides, there are some options more that this device is bringing. So we built this solution together with our cooperation partner Metis. It's a high quality scanner manufacturer based in Italy. And this software, or this solution, is a complete software suite to acquire, transform, and output a surface description. So you can use the Surface 3D with all the advantages just explained it, that the RC is bringing to do a color characterization, ICC profiling, but you can also acquire color from a template, as well as the surface structure and the glossiness, the reflectance properties of a template. You can exchange it with a dedicated software, and if you have reached your final result, you send it back to the production server, which is then generating color-managed print data together with the embossing mapped and a glossiness map that you can use to control a cloth ink, for example. The emboss map can be used in ceramics to control a sinking ink, and then you can send all these files to your ceramic printer, but also to a roll-a-roll printer, UV flatbed printer, or what kind of printer ever. I think this was more or less the last slide. I will have another video, it's just 1 minute, that show you a little bit the possibilities of this solution, and you can also see the measurement process. You can also stitch larger originals if they don't fit in one shot into the scanner. And the stitching will be done automatically by the software. After you have scanned your template, you can play with the light without the need to rescan it again. So you can have a look at the impression, how do you want to have it. Here is a stone, it's more related to ceramics. You can display different maps like the structure map, the glossiness map. You can evaluate this in 3D. Map the 3D. in this video, but not that much. So the whole process maybe takes 2 to 3 minutes. After that, you have calculated your profile. So thank you very much for your attentions.